Hi, I'm Master Sergeant Ward Yeager, Trumpet Section Leader with the United States Army Field Band. We're honored and excited to be a part of the International Trumpet Guild's Listen and Learn project. Today, we want to talk about a very important topic, recording. Many job auditions, including here at the Army Field Band, begin with a preliminary recorded round. Learning how to record is just as important as how you prepare the music. You need a setup that best represents your sound, musicianship, and abilities. Making music virtually is more important now than ever before. In this video, we'll share some creative ways you can continue making music from home, as well as a few simple tips to help you make the best recordings possible. Thanks for watching, and please enjoy.
Hi, I'm Staff Sergeant Ryan Brewer. For many auditions these days, a digital recording is required when you submit a resume. And in a lot of ways, your recording is your resume. On a recorded round, the panel has to assume that this is the candidate's best playing, so if the recording isn't up to a professional standard, it just wastes everyone's time. I've had the privilege of being on both sides of an audition, and when I'm on a panel, I want every player to be set up for success and play their best. Basically, if you know how to produce a good recording, you can get in the door for just about any audition. That's where your ability to record comes in, and there's no more convenient place to record than your own home. Another obvious benefit of recording is that, in combination with critical listening, it's one of the fastest ways to improve your craft. If you can cultivate the skills of playing, listening, recording, and producing music, you'll open yourself up to a lot of opportunities.
And finally, while musical organizations continue to adapt and change, the ability to perform high-quality musical content on your own is more important than it's ever been. Recording technology, including mobile recording apps, let you record and layer multiple tracks together, alone, allowing us to still perform ensemble music in a way. But recording with yourself is not the same as recording with other players, and it brings very different challenges and different opportunities for self-awareness and growth. Educating yourself in the recording process is an extremely worthwhile endeavor right now, as well as composing, arranging, video production, and any other related interest you have that can help you build and maintain your creative voice. Until live performances become more commonplace again, building up a body of work on your website or social media channels is a great way to stay relevant and keep your skills sharp.
Hi, I'm Master Sergeant Nick Althaus, and I want to offer a few words about equipment and basic setup to get a good sound quality on your recordings. There are ways to record on a budget, although I would encourage you to spend your money on professional level equipment if at all possible, especially when it comes to microphones. Set up properly, a quality professional mic will capture a more accurate sound than most consumer grade gadget plugins and last for decades. The microphones I have here are each 20 to 25 years old and have survived DAT recorders, mini disc recorders, and a number of flash and SD field recorders. You can record directly to standalone recorders with built-in or external microphones, or to your computer or tablet with an audio interface. Whatever recorder or device you choose, look for something capable of recording in an uncompressed or lossless format. Just as we spend countless hours trying to find the sweet spot in every note on the trumpet, take the time to find the sweet spot in both your mic and recording space. This deals mainly with axis, or how directly your bell is pointed toward the mic, distance from the bell, and reflection of sound in your room. Starting out, position yourself 4 to 6 feet from the mic, playing between 20 and 40 degrees off axis. If you are too close to the mic or playing too directly at the elements, the sound will be bright and harsh from picking up only the most directional parts of your sound. Having too much distance between the bell and microphone, or playing off axis to the point of being out of the pickup pattern of the mic, often result in capturing mostly reflected sound or sounding soft and distant. A cheap consumer-grade mic can often sound bad no matter where it's placed. The best result with this $30 vocal mic sounds small and distant, yet retains the brightness of the directional sound that we heard from the too close example. Remember, find the sweet spot, a balance of clarity of attack, fullness and richness of sound, and resonance of the room you're in, with the goal of conveying an accurate picture of your playing to the listener. Have fun experimenting, creating, and learning during the recording process, and do the best with whatever equipment and space you have access to.
Thank you so much for watching. We appreciate you being here with us. This video was a lot of fun to put together, and we hope you came away with some useful recording tips. It's an honor for our section to be part of the Listen and Learn project, and we'd like to thank the International Trumpet Guild for including us. If you'd like more information about the Army Field Band, please check out our website at armyfieldband.com. For more educational resources and performance videos, check us out on YouTube or find us on Facebook, Twitter, or Instagram. Until next time, take care, stay healthy, and be safe. Happy practicing.